national championships is just coming on so fast. The girls, the juniors, and the seniors here in St. Louis. Then, of course, the Grand Chess Tour next month will come
to St. Louis.
And they're off.
Yeah, and now we see e4 being the weapon of choice.
Oh my gosh, open Sicilian. None of this bishop b5 check. None of these.
Yeah, we see knight c3.
Knight orf. And boy, was MDL excited to get in his knight orf.
And queen d3 following
once again.
All the rage.
Wow. I am mystified by the vagaries of fashion. Castles. So it's like a dragon.
Hell, wasn't this the delayed Zagreb variation?
The delayed Zagreb. That's what
Christian and
Fabi called it. Dubbed it. I mean, it was his right. Okay. Big pause after the move h2, h3, as you start to think to yourself, well, how am I going to complete my development on the queen side? I would like to get in b5, and the move queen c7 is a usual prelude, if you will, to getting in b5. Now, in this particular case, b5, knight d5 might be a very discouraging knight takes d5, e takes d5. Oh, wait a minute. b5, knight d5, knight takes d5. Still not so clear to me, because knight c6 is met by a powerful reaction, knight e5, and he did play b5.
He has gone for that, and of course, e5 for white is unattractive. Because, yes, you might win a rook at the end of it, but
this is small problem.
Knight takes pawn.
Correct.
You lose the queen.
That's correct.
And
knight d5.
Knight d5 indeed played.
Knight e5. Okay, queen e2. So I assume his intention is to put his bishop on d7 in this case. I'm not quite sure. No, bishop to b7. So I thought he was going to start with bishop b7, actually. And he started with knight e5. The reason why I'm just pausing here, because f4,
knight c4,
knight c6 is the idea.
And then you've got moves like e5.
That is a good point. e5, I don't have quite the grip I want. So I have to rein in my horns and play a move like
c3. b3, keeping the idea on tap, because f4, knight d7, and then the b7 pawn was potentially loose. That's why rook e8 has been played.
Quickly, too.
Bishop e3 was the response. Maybe also you could think about queen to d2. And you can kind of play this like a d4 type position where you threaten bishop h6.
Yeah,
you shift your rook over to e1. You pretend that it was never on d1 in the first place.
Or the queen was never on d3 or e2.
Okay,
yeah.
Well, we see queen.
We'll be right back. That's a
so
huge.
That is absolutely crucial for the standings, because if Maxime manages to win, he'll be a point ahead.
H4? No, he went F4. Usually in such positions, the idea is to maintain the F5 pawn to keep the bishop passive and to put the pawn on H4. But he's
doing this really, really well. Okay, and how decision time do you take the rooks? Do you change the nature of the game?
Unfortunately, it's not enough if we trade the rooks. We really need the rook on the second rank. He should go back to d2, by the way, and put the knight on e4. Rook to d2, check. He played knight e4 immediately. Not good, not good.
Yeah, I assume. Check.
Now, black put himself into a pin.
Yeah, he can get out of it, though, with the king up to g5.
Oh, sure, but it would entail the trade of the rook side, is what I'm saying.
Yeah.
So this is a dream for white. Keep those pawns on h5 and g4.
And okay, well, we see the trade of rooks.
And the bishop has a role. Bishop to e8.
And now Maxime to 8 seconds. And we just see Fabiano building up some time on the clock, just moving the bishop
past
from one square to the other.
Correct.
Now this is the thing, Maxime has put his pawns on light squares.
Exactly.
The black king can never run too close.
Precisely.
To the white king.
And of course, MVL has to play it out because the victory is so important. 9f6.
Bishop f7.
Trying to get his king, but with the pawns on the light squares.
Yep, and the players made eye contact. They agreed a draw.
What a save!
What a save from Fabiano.
Two pawns up
for MVL. Also, what a miss.
Yes.
Especially in that race for second place.